Hello everybody, and let us continue for where we previously stopped. So what we did is basically we ran this command in the previous video and we created our Windows payload, or basically our Windows reverse shell. So what we want to do right now is, first of all, if you just want to deliver this to someone, there are two things you need to do. Basically set up a listener on the same port that you specified in the payload, and of course you need to have the same IP address as well. And what you want to do next is basically just deliver the payload any way you want, over email, over USB drive, over some link, or however you want to deliver it. But before we do that, let us see how we can actually craft a little bit better payload. Now, that will not be much better. The real antivirus bypass we will do in the next section, basically where we actually code our own tools and actually add the binary in order to prevent antiviruses from actually detecting our program. But since this is a well-known payload that everybody uses, it will be known to the antiviruses. So first of all, what you want to do is go to the Firefox, and there is a site, as I said in the previous video, which is called Antivirus or Virus Total or something like that, which basically allows you, let me just type in your Google search bar Virus Total, and it should be the first thing that pops up, I believe. As I said, it is the website that allows us to upload our files, and it will print out a list of how many antivirus detect that file as a virus. But be careful if you're creating a serious virus or a serious payload or something like that. Make sure to not actually use this website, since every time you upload something to this website, it gets sent to the antivirus databases. So if you, for example, upload a virus that you created or coded, which gets detected by like 2% or 3% of antivirus, which is like really, really good, in a few days or weeks, it actually will be detected by a lot more, since this website actually sends that value of that virus to the databases, and then they update it, and then every other antivirus software will actually start detecting your program as a virus as well, in case it is a virus, of course. So what you want to do right here, but first of all, since this payload that we created is just a simple reverse TCP interpreter shell, which is already uploaded on this website 1,000 times and 100,000 times, we can safely upload it, since it will get detected by every antivirus anyway. So what we want to go is navigate to our root directory where we saved the file. So here it is, reverse.exe, size is 7.2 kilobytes, and we basically double click on this file, or we can click on open, and it will say confirm file upload, you have chosen the file named reverse.exe, do you want to continue? We click here on yes, and it will basically upload the file for us. It will scan it, and what it will do is it will print out all of the antivirus that detect and that do not detect this program as a virus. So we can see already a lot of them detected it, basically out of 65, 67, 70, 44 detected it already. Now all of these that actually didn't detect, so let me just reload this page so it can print out it well. So we can see the final result is 45 out of 75 antiviruses detected this as a virus. So if you scroll down to those who didn't really detect it as a virus, you will see that these are not some of the more known antiviruses. So these basically, I don't know if they even get updated. Some of these I have never even heard of. Most known antiviruses are up, and those are the ones that actually detected it, such as Bitdefender, Avast, which actually you need to know that the Bitdefender is probably the best antivirus that you can get for free. It detects a lot of viruses, and basically it will be really hard to bypass these antiviruses, I will show you later on. But for example, Avast, which is I believe one of the most used ones in the world, is actually not that hard to bypass. So what we want to do, so let us check out the result. So 45 out of 71. So what we want to do right now, first of all, we want to refresh this page, and let us see if we can lower that number even a little bit. So even two or three antiviruses will be good. I mean, it will not be good, but better something than nothing, right? So let us actually run the same command that we ran before and create a second payload. But before we do that, let us see our available, actually, let me just change my directory, our available encoders. So not payloads, we want to go to the encoders. And since we create a 64-bit version of the meterpreter reverse TCP, we want to go to x64. And as I said, there are not many for this, so we can actually use this one, for example. So let us change to the root directory once again. And so we do not type the command entirely, let me just find it. Okay, so here it is. And what we want to specify is minus E, and then I believe x64, and then the name of the encoder. I believe it is specified with minus E, and then after that minus I for the number of iterations it should actually pass. So we will just specify five iterations. I believe that is by default. Now, I hope this is the syntax. If it is not, we will have to run the help command in order to see what the correct syntax for this is. But let's see what this will do. Now, if this does work, skipping invalid encoder. So let me just see, maybe we do not need to specify the .ruby file. Let us see. Now, you know that the skipping invalid encoder. So let us see msf venom minus minus help. Now, let us see for the encoder to use list encoder to list. So let us see msf venom minus c and I believe list or something like that. So attempting to read payload from standard input. We do not want that. Oh, list encoders to list. Okay. So what we want to type is msf venom list encoders. So we can see our available encoder. Okay, so let us find the one that we want to use. Now, it is this one, so I didn't need to specify the forward slash at the beginning, so that's why it gave us an error. So let us run the same command once again, and let us rename this to reverse one, so it actually differentiates it from the previous one. And I believe this is the command right now. So it will use this encoder, and it will run through five iterations, and you will notice that the file will be a little bit bigger than the previous reverse.txt file. So here we can see that it actually ran through five iterations. Now if you specified here more, it will run through more. Basically the more the better, but the more iterations you use, the file will be bigger. So we can see that the payload size is not anymore 510 bytes, it is right now 768 bytes. And we can see that if I type here ls, our reverse.1.exe is there. So we used encoder, and now let's see, let us see if it will get the same results as this file right here. So this first file, which is the simplest one, got 45 out of 71. So let us go back, just click on this icon right here, which will lead you to the welcome page once again. And what we want to do right here is basically choose file as in the previous file, and we want to select the reverse1.exe. If I click here open, it will ask us once again if I want to confirm. So I click here OK, and it will upload the file. And let's see how many antiviruses catch it now. Now it will still be a big number, but I believe it should be smaller than 45. Since this is an available encoder in Metasploit, and all the other people use it as well. So it is not that new of a process in order to create an undetectable payload. So let us see, for now on, we can see 3 out of 3 antiviruses detected it. Not really sure why it goes this slow, it should go a little bit faster. Maybe it takes more time for antiviruses to detect it, not really sure why. But this is really slow for now. So 5 out of 8 for now on. We know that there is around 70 or something like that, 71 I believe, antiviruses that are in this website that actually scan the file that we upload. So let's hope for the better result than in the previous scan. So for now 18 out of 32 detected. As we can see, it is growing. It is still growing. But I believe that we will not go over 45. So this should be a better result than in the previous scan, which means that we were able to actually bypass some of the antiviruses in this website, which is good. So better something than nothing. For now it's 32. Let us see how much this will grow, so we can calculate the exact number of antiviruses that we were able to bypass. So 35 out of 62. Not really sure why this scan is taking so long. But there is one thing that you might have noticed. Let me just try to find it. Okay, never mind. I was trying to find the Avast antiviruses. Antivirus, I thought we actually were able to bypass it with this simple encoder, but we were not able to, since it is still detecting it as an virus. So that's good for the Avast, but it's still not that good of an antivirus program. Now, I both have the on my PC, I both have the Avast antivirus and the Bitdefender antivirus, because I wanted to test something. Basically, the Bitdefender is a lot better than the Avast, in my opinion. Now you can use any you want, but as an experienced hacker, you would probably not want to use any at all, since antivirus can only slow down your PC, and if you actually know what to click and what not to click, you really do not need it on your PC. For example, on my laptop, I do not have antivirus at all. So let's see how long this will take. We can actually stop it right now. I believe there are like four antiviruses left, which basically leaves us, if all four detected, at 41 out of 70, which is four antiviruses better than the previous scan, which is something, right? So we were able to actually bypass some of the antiviruses. As we can see right now, only 38 detected out of 67. Now, the last time we had 70 antiviruses, but sometimes it puts more, it puts less. What matters is that we were able to bypass some of them. But let's see if we can put this number even at smaller rate. So what we want to do, first of all, we want to use the same file that we were actually created, so the reverse 1.txt, and we want to use a tool that is called Hex Edit. It opens it as a hex code, and what you can do is change the values of it. So we can just open it. Let me show you Hex Edit. So Hex Editor, and then the name of the file, which in our case is reverse 1.txt. And what you will see right here is basically our program in bytes. So be very careful. I mean, you do not need to be careful, since it takes like 2 seconds to create this payload. But if you change just one byte that you shouldn't change, your program will not work. Now, there are a few things that we know that we can change, which are basically this right here, which is this program cannot be run in DOS mode. So we can change that value, since we know it is a string and it doesn't actually perform anything in a code. It is more likely a comment or something like that. Now, why are we changing that? Well, as I said, how antiviruses work is basically they have a huge database, and there they have the signature values of all the viruses. Now, if you just simply change, for example, just one byte, it will be different than the virus that they have in the database. So just changing and switching up a simple bytes in a whole program can make you bypass some of the antiviruses. So what you want to do is first navigate right here. You navigate with arrows, as you can see right here. And once you reach the bytes that actually correspond to this string, you can just type here anything, as we can see. Oops, I should have started in the upper line. As we can see, while I type here, which I changed to D8 or DD right now, it is changing the values of this string. So if I just go AAAAA and then DD and then some random numbers, you will see that the values right here change. Oops, I accidentally typed W, which you cannot use in bytes. Basically, you can only use A, B, C, D, E, F and numbers 1, 2 through 9 with 0. So let us just use some of the random ones, so just type right here. Make sure not to pass the last letter, since if you pass it, basically you will enter a different part of the code, which can actually make a program not run. Now, this is not the only thing that we can change in this program, but for now on, it will be good. Now, once we code our own programs, I will show you what else you can change in order to bypass more antiviruses. But for now on, let's see if I save this, so file name reverse1.txt, and if I close this, so Ctrl-O to save, Enter to select file name, and Ctrl-X to exit, and now let's see once again, if I open it, you will see this string is no longer there. Now, let's try to upload it once again and see if we get even better result than the last time. So, what we want to go, so go right here once again, choose a file, and we go to reverse1.exe. Open it, since we use the reverse1.exe, since that is the file that we actually changed in the Hex editor. So, open it, it will ask us the standard questions. Do we want to upload it? We say yes. And right now it will analyze the virus once again. So last time I believe we got like 40 or 38. So let's see if we can get less than 38 right now. Now what I did right here, where I changed that string, is also a well-known thing to do. So most of the hackers actually do that as well, so it is not that big of a thing in order to change the in order to bypass some of the antiviruses, but it should be good enough to bypass at least some of them or a few of them. But looking like this, we might actually not bypass any, since it is already at 36. Yeah, what we actually got more that detected it than in the previous scan. So that's a little bit weird, but it happens. So some antiviruses work weird, but some antiviruses don't work weird. Let us see just how many antiviruses will it scan. If it scans like 70, we might be able to actually bypass like one of them. Since last time it only scanned like 68 or 67 or something like that. But right now it already scanned 69. With 69 antiviruses, and 39 out of those 69 detected it, which is still a bad number, but we actually were able to lower it from the first scan. So those are just some of the simple things to do in order to bypass it. Let us just wait for this scan to finish. So 40 out of 70. That is not that bad. I mean, it is still bad, but if you remember the first one, it was 45 out of 70. So we were able to bypass 5 antiviruses. And that is good enough if the target is using one of those 5. So that will be about it for this tutorial of bypassing antiviruses. Now, the more advanced antiviruses bypass we will do in the coding section. For now on, it is good to only know these simple things. It will get you only as far, but it is still better than nothing. And in the next video, we will actually run this on our Windows 10 machine. We'll run the payload that we created. So that will be it for this video, and I hope I see you in the next one. Bye.